Along the coast, in Wildwood, a different kind of teardown has invaded the shore. At risk is the largest collection of mid-20th century resort architecture in the country.
Many people, when I mention this, they'll say, "Why? What's he talking about with Wildwood? That's not historic." But you know what it is? They're 50 years old, and that's kind of the rule. And it's not that everything needs to be preserved, but the character of Wildwood is changing because there's been so many demolitions of historic motels and hotels down there.
In the 1950s and 60s, Wildwood was a major destination for newly mobile families. The construction of the Garden State Parkway and cars built for cruising made it easy for vacationers to reach this seaside resort. The popular music of the era inspired the name for the eye-catching style of architecture in Wildwood, referred to as Doo Wop. Fun, imaginative, and surprising. These family-owned motels attracted attention with dazzling neon, Miami Beach-inspired designs, and popular themes of the 50s and 60s. Vacationers could spend their time in the tropics or the space age. Jack Morey's family built many of these vintage places.
The Doo Wop hotels and the design of Doo Wop hotels are essentially about the future. When you attempt to be futuristic, you're trying to design something that is almost theme park-like. You're trying to put somebody in sort of another place, in another environment. Other themes, and one of the sort of more popular ones, would really be South Pacific. This was right after a war. GIs were back from the war, they experienced a new place, they had stories to tell, and all of a sudden that became a vacation opportunity or a design opportunity for families.
They really represent a whole way of life for several generations of families from New Jersey and all over the East Coast. Families who came every single summer, and still do, to stay in the motels and go on the boardwalk and play on the beach. And that architectural style and the whole sort of life history, lifestyle that went with them is being rapidly lost.
More than 100 Doo Wop buildings have faced the wrecking ball.
In the peak of teardowns, there were probably two or three teardowns a week.
The pressure to demolish these vintage places increased when land values escalated. This led to the construction of a vast sea of condominiums where small family-owned motels once stood.
Unfortunately, we went from sort of a sleepy, stable economy to a boomtown overnight. And we had no zoning, no ordinances in place to save these buildings. So for the people who owned them, to make a lot of money overnight was a blessing. But for those of us who were trying to preserve the buildings, it was a curse.
Major studies recognize the significance of Doo Wop architecture. This drew attention to Wildwood from around the world and sparked the development of the Doo Wop Preservation League.
The mission of the organization was really to reinvent the buildings. It was to convince people that there was a future. It was to convince people that rather than tearing down, there was a real opportunity to do what other communities have done well, other communities like Cape May or South Beach in Miami.
The owners of places like the Caribbean and the Shalimar have updated their classic motels into 21st century resorts with a Doo Wop twist.
The best of Doo Wop is still here. There's still over 6,000 Doo Wop hotel rooms. It's just hidden amongst a lot of condos, and that's why we try to spotlight it so people know what's there.
It's my hope that time has not run out. I think the community finally recognizes that there is a real strong market opportunity here. I just hope it's not too late, because a lot of these properties are gone.
To order a copy of Our Vanishing Past, please call NJN Video at 609-777-5093 or visit njn.net.